I've looked at the market for convertible Firebirds, and if done right, they're going for $40,000 to $75,000. Sometimes, if you can get a Firebird built just right, it can fetch upwards of six figures. This one's easy cash so long as we get it done quick and efficient. So I've got all the parts to make it badass already on the way.
We're on a 10-day deadline to knock the ugly off the 67 Firebird and build it into a car with some gas monkey style. Richard pre-ordered all the parts, from a crate motor to the new suspension, so we can get this bad boy done on time.
See, a guy that carries a flat spare tire is not a smart man.
What's your over and under on skull count?
I say you got 12. You said 13, right?
Yeah, I'm going to say, look.
I'm going to shoot one low just because.
Four skulls on the wheels. We had our door lock skull.
That's right.
Six.
Seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12. I'm money.
Please give me some skulls on them license plates back there.
Nope, they're spikes.
Nope, negative.
So what do I win, Mike?
You win a date with Jeremy.
You're buying.
Another one?
Yeah. I'm starting to understand Sue when she says Richard always brings me junk.
Yeah.
I feel like he does that to us, too.
I'm starting to agree with that a lot more.
First red flag of the day was when we got the car in position to tear it down, the passenger door wouldn't open.
Yeah,
it just stopped working. Just fine, and all of a sudden, now it doesn't work.
I think someone sat on the lock getting in it.
Bet the linkage.
This door's broke here, too. And broke here.
And it's usually something like that, and it's a snowball effect.
I think these quarters are too far forward.
And you're positive quarters have been put in?
No, I'm not positive. That's what I'm saying.
I have no idea.
I can look inside. They may be original, Mike, because I got rust here.
The trunk pan is not, and there's fiberglass all over
the
back.
Yeah, the whole bottom is fiberglass.
Well, then it's been hacked up then. And sure enough, as we got the car further apart, we started finding signs.
I can already tell you, it looks like there's been floor pan put in.
And it's a convertible, so if they don't do it
right. That's factory, though. All this is factory.
Yeah, but this isn't.
No, yeah. And when we pulled the carpet back, we found that the entire floor of the car had been cut out and really poorly welded back on top of it.
If they didn't do it correctly, that body could talk to him. Being a convertible like that, you don't have roof structure, so really all of it relies on your floor. And if they just threw these pans in and over time that car had sagged like this, could be an issue why we're having a problem with our doors fitting.
Look at this, it's all gone. I mean, the whole floor's coming out of it.
That's the worst floor I've ever seen in a car. See this?
Yeah, it's terrible.
Just look at the jagged metal. They just literally chopped it, and then laid the other floor on top of it. They didn't even take the old floor out.
There's just no car left.
The rail connectors are the only thing holding the car together. We cannot ethically put this car back together.
You couldn't attach anything to another thing.
No, it has to all be cut out.
It's a bad one.
We just need another car. Normally, we buy a car, and then we find a donor.
Yeah.
This is kind of our donor. Can we find a car?
I don't know. I mean, we've got it torn up and it's in the middle of the garage.
At this point, send it out the door, start with a fresh car, maybe take some parts off of this car, and then send it out to the crusher. You don't want to give anybody that car on purpose.
All right, let me get online and see if I can find a 67 convertible that's for sale today.
Yeah, we need one today. Tomorrow we got to get going.
We'll go look at it and scoop it up today.
Yeah.
Because right now we're dead in the water.
I hear road trip.
I'm glad y'all are excited about wasting my money.
Told you I'd throw it in the gutter.
We should put this thing down before it falls on someone.
Russell gives me a call because he's out gallivanting around the Northeast, and I'm here in Texas sweating it out, trying to figure out what we're going to do with this Firebird.
We have opened Pandora's box.
What? The 67 Firebird?
I mean, this is probably the worst car we've ever had at Gas Monkey.
That's saying a lot.
I got to figure out what I'm going to do now. I don't know where I'm at right now. I'm scouring the nation right now for one.
Well, as long as I have you, you're okay. I'll keep an eye out for a convertible Firebird. Chin up, little guy. That's why I'm your fixer, right?
Just don't spend more than 20 or 22 grand on it.
Okay, sayonara, sucker.
I got the door.
What an ass whipping.
Who is this?
Oh, look at that.
How's that for? Well, there you go. That's the real car.
How's that for service? If it looks good underneath, then I'm happy.
Well, aren't you just the
aren't you timely?
The savior for this. We were just talking about how bad
I knew
that
something
car
was up when you weren't answering my phone calls.
Well, it's hard to hear anything with the top down, and it's a longer drive than I thought it was going to be. But you said you needed one because that thing was a mess.
So you drove us in from New York?
Yeah, baby.
What's amazing is your hair is still perfect.
It actually is. I was like this most of the way.
Got it.
This is a different hood and stuff. Still same car, though, right?
Yeah, I mean, same body.
Same car. Same year.
What'd I buy this for?
25 for it to be in the condition it's in.
Jesus.
But you're not finding one like this, especially with what you guys have in mind on it.
Richard had paid what I thought was too much for the white car. Now he's having to kick out 25 grand for the red car, which seems like a lot of money, but this is a really solid car. It runs, drives, obviously. You know, it's just made a 1,500-mile trek. Now we have a parts car, and we have a buildable car. And for us, that's the ideal situation to build what we want. Cool it out, change the color for sure.
Speaking of colors, what are you thinking? You still want copper?
I want to go with a combination of gunmetal black and that bronze on the wheels.
Weren't we kind of gunmetaled out right now?
I want it to be different. All that anybody ever does is that.
We've already got a motor coming, transmission. Everything is already on its way here.
We have to start all over with this Firebird. With everything I've spent on this project, I'm down 35 grand before we even touched it. But convertibles are always popular, and this will be a high-powered cruiser like none other. All the cool stuff I already ordered, that all stays. Never mind the copper, painted a sexy gunmetal gray. I originally gave the guys 10 days on the build, but I reset the clock and still gave the monkeys 10 whole days to build it. They better move it. I'll sell that, you know, for $5,000-$6,000. Put the money back in the bank and off we go.
Hey, that works.
Cool. All
right, killer. I can sell these wheels. Good job, man.
Hey, man, thanks. Woo! We need to go over some toll receipts and some gas receipts. It took a little bit to get down here.
I'm trying to get these brake-ons off, get this master out of the way. Once this is out of the way, I'm about to take the power steering box out of the way, too, and then disconnect the transmission. We can either pull the whole motor and transmission out, or we can take the subframe loose and just roll the whole thing away. We'll see where we get here in a minute. Once they're ready, we'll pull it up to the lift and make the decision. We'll either pull that out or pull it out either way. Things coming apart here in a minute. If we pull the front subframe, we get to take the whole thing as one chunk, which separates it from the body, hopefully getting it to paint quicker. But if we take it piece by piece right here, it's a lot easier to manage because it's bolted to the car, it's stationary, you can really wrench on it. When you take it apart and roll it off, it's very awkward and cumbersome and doesn't really like to stay there. So it might cost us a little more time there, but at least we get the body over and get it going, because that's really what we're trying to do.
Nice.
So it's kind of nice. I think this is all like we were talking about the rest of it. It's all kind of been restored, gone through. Nice new bolts and everything inside the interior. Someone's been through the interior. It's coming apart pretty nice. What do you think, John?
Yeah, I think so.
Looking good under the dash?
Yeah.
Push the lever. There you go.
All right. Winner, winner.
All right, off to the sandblaster.
Hell yeah.
I don't think we're going anytime soon.
Doesn't look like it.
Shit, it's raining.
Good spot.
The biggest adversary of our sandblaster is rain. It won't allow them to actually sandblast because of the moisture in the air. Everything's at a halt now. So all that time we made up in the last day and a half, now we gotta sit and wait. The problem is what's called flash rust. Raw bare metal can corrode with just high humidity. So to avoid it when it's raining out, our blaster, well, he just shuts down.
Did you hear it? But no worries. This storm will blow over and it'll be sunny tomorrow. I can feel it in my bones. Okay, I'm a better painter than I am a weatherman. We gotta wait for the rain to stop before we can take the Firebird body over to sandblast. So in the meantime, me and the boys will go ahead and get the doors and the other panels ready for metalwork.
Okay, hold on. We're taking it all, right?
Every panel has something small.
Let's take them all.
But it's all small stuff. Since we've been stuck in this weather delay, we've managed to strip down all the panels to bare metal. So now we just need a little bit of metal work.
No emblem holes. And then, like, here's a little bit of rust just in the normal spots.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you, guys.
You're welcome.
You know, the damage isn't too bad on these. It's always typical. There's a brace right here. Water, dirt, clogs up in there, rots out the corners. So cut it out, cleaned the rust, treated the brace to make sure it wouldn't keep rusting, sealed it all with some weld-through primer, and that way they have something good to do their Bondo over, and if you leave all the rust and all the holes, it's just gonna blister back through your bodywork. So patch that up for Mike and the boys over there, make sure that their bodywork's gonna hold up, and then shaved all the emblem holes out, and the spindle will be ready to go back.